Hello, my dear students. Hope you all are well at home. I am Anjana Jindal and I welcome you all in my moral science class. So children, today I am back here with chapter number 3, Grandpa Grandma of our moral science book. It's part 2, and in part 1 of this chapter I had explained you the story, and now in this video I am going to discuss the question answers and exercises of this chapter. Okay, so let's learn. Now children, here are the words said by some great personalities. So let us remember. See the words of Saint Chavra. A family is blessed where children live with their siblings, parents and grandparents in mutual love and respect. Such family is a heaven on earth. Yes, very truly it is said, like that family is the blessed one in which all the children are living with their siblings, means brothers, sisters, their parents and grandparents, with a mutual love and respect, sharing love with each other. That family seems to be a heaven on earth nowadays. Now the words of Regina Brett. If you are lucky enough to still have grandparents, visit them, cherish them and celebrate them while you can. Yes children, those who are lucky ones, those who have the grandparents, they are very lucky. So they should always visit, time to time they should visit their grandparents and should cherish them, celebrate with them. Isn't it? Yes. So learn these words. So children, now let's move to the exercises which are given at the back of your chapter. Let us find out the answers. See, here the questions are given and I have given the answers for as well. Right, I'll read for you. Question number 1. Who took Jyoti to the dance class? Children, who took Jyoti? Yes, Grandpa. Grandpa took Jyoti to the dance class. Question number 2. What was grandmother's advice to Jyoti? Write in 2 short sentences. Here you have to give your answer in 2 short sentences. See, grandmother advised Jyoti to develop her good talents. She also advised Jyoti to thank God for his help. Question number 3. How did Grandpa console Jyoti in her pain? Grandpa consoled Jyoti by telling her to be practical and not to worry about gossip. Question number 4. What did Jyoti say after receiving the prize? So Jyoti thanked her grandparents for their love and support.
So children, our next exercise is, let us write. So see the question. Write 3 ways by which you can express your love for your grandpa and grandma. So children, 3 ways I have written for you. First one, by greeting them. Second one, by taking care of them. Third one, by spending time with them. So children, these are the 3 ways which I have listed. Okay, there may be so many ways, right? So the way you express your love towards your grandparents, those ways you can write. Okay, so now children, next exercise I have given you in your home assignment. Let us fill in the blanks. So this you have to do with your own. Okay, let's see. Number 1, the name of your grandfather is Dash. So children, here you have to fill the name of your grandfather. Okay. Number 2, the name of my grandmother is Dash. So in this blank, you have to fill the name of your grandmother. Now number 3, my grandfather's favorite work is Dash. So here you have to write down the favorite work of your grandfather. Okay. Now number 4, my grandmother's favorite dish is dash. So in this blank you have to fill the favorite dish of your grandmother. Okay children. So now children, I hope you all have understood the chapter very well, and most importantly the importance of our grandparents in our lives, isn't it? Yes. So children, with this our chapter is completed. So bye bye, take care. Thank you for watching the videos.